Hi there, welcome to Kevvy Shaves. Nice to see you again, it's nice to be here. The razor for today, I've not used this for quite a while, so I'm giving it a go. This is the Merkur 37C, the slant. And you can see the slant on that. This is a two-piece razor, kind of like the 34C. You unscrew the bottom and the head comes off. And inside that, I have a brand new Zorik Super Platinum blade, and these were gifted to me from Alex DeLeon. So he suggested trying, I can't remember if it was these or the other ones, but I'm going to use these. And to screw this down, you just tighten the bottom up again, and I'll just check the blade alignment, and that seems fine. And just make sure it's tight, and there it is there, and there's the slant. I'll just show you the packaging for the Zorik Super Platinum blades. There's the box, and there is the wrapper. And I'm not sure if these are made by Supermax, because it said on the back, for best results use Supermax shaving foam. Yeah, these are, that's the packaging there. They're made in India. And the good thing about these, I like these blades, is they're double wrapped. They come in, the blade comes in this wax paper, so there's not any glue spots on it. So that's the razor and that's the blade for today. The soap for today is Stash Soapworks E-Barber. This again was in the box that Alex sent me very kindly. Erica Salmons put some soaps and balms and stuff in the box as well, so this was in amongst it all, so I'm going to use that today. And the scent on this, I'm just going to give you the notes: oak moss, white pepper, vanilla, black amber, cedarwood, bergamot, basil leaf, clove, nutmeg, white patchouli, musk, saffron, rose, patchouli and vetiver. A lot of scents going on in there, and it does smell quite floral, which I guess is the rose. But if Erica's watching this, I want to know, what's the difference between white patchouli and patchouli? Is there a difference? I don't know. Maybe like white pepper and black pepper. White pepper is slightly more bitter and stronger. So that's the soap I'm going to be using for today. And I'm going to bowl lather in the Kevvy Shaves bowl, which I will show you now. And there's the Kevvy Shaves bowl. And I've whipped up the lather using the Amiga S brush. This is a synthetic brush. I'll just take some of the suds off to show you. Yeah, it's a synthetic brush. And this was given to me by Dave Card. Thank you, Dave. Really appreciate that. And here's the lather here from the E-Barber, and I don't know whether you can see it, but look at the shine on that. It is just incredible. And yeah, the scent in the bowl is really nice. Really, really nice. And there's all the soap, the suds in there. And I thought actually this could be, I thought this was going to be a Scottish soap, because it can take a good drink. Yeah, don't be scared to add water to your soaps if you're bowl lathering. Just add a little at a time. But I found with this, the more I whipped it up and just kept adding water, it just kept producing more and more. And I think the more water you add, the more silky finish it will get. So yeah, it can take a lot of water, so it's a good soap. Okay, I'm just going to wet my face and then we shall lather up. I still have this ridiculous goatee beard, but for those of you that don't know, I'm going to play at the end of the month. Next week it starts, and my character requires me to have a handlebar moustache, so this will be coming off next week. Okay, let's get the lather going with the E-Barber Stash Soapworks. I hope you're all well, having some nice shaves and in good health, and I hope 2017 is starting off as a good year for you. This is a nice little brush. It's got great backbone in it. And it splays really nice. Yeah, it was easy to whip up the lather in that soap. Actually, you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to show you the soap. There's the soap there, and as you can see, I scraped some off and put it in the bowl, and you know how I do it, don't you, with a teaspoon. I just scrape the top of the soap, and you get little flakes of soap. And Ronnie Greer really likes doing it this way. So, well done, Ronnie. That's it. Yeah, just use a teaspoon, but just be sure to wash the teaspoon after. Don't go making coffee with a soapy spoon. So, there we go there, and I'll just show you the ingredients. You can pause that and take a look. Okay, we'll carry on lathering up. Yeah, what was I saying? I can't remember. Yeah, that's what I bowl lathered with the E-Barber. That's how I do it. Depending on if it's a harder soap or not. The Kevvy Shaves teaspoon technique. Mrs. Kevvy doesn't know that I use the teaspoons to scrape the soap, but we won't tell her. It's our secret. And this is whipping up a nice, nice lather in the bowl. I don't need any more on that. Yeah, so I hope you're having some nice shaves and life's treating you well. And I know that Erica, that runs things at Stash Soapworks, Erica and Nicole, I know that Erica hasn't been keeping well too late, hasn't been keeping too well lately. So I hope you're on the mend, Erica, and I hope you're feeling better. And I hope Nicole's looking after you. Okay, that looks nice. Nice lather. Okay, let's just get some heat in the blade. Someone asked me why do I put the blade in hot water. It was Nigel Bourne. He said, why do you put the blade? Well, just to get some heat in the blade, and a cold blade doesn't feel nice on your skin. And if it's a little bit more warm, it will glide over the skin better. Okay, let's get the shave on. And again, this soap is very nice. Nice glide on it. As is the Zorik blade. And yeah, the giveaway video is still open. If you haven't commented on the giveaway video, I shall put the link for the video in the description of this shave. And you just need a comment. Just leave a comment, but just leave I'm in. But you can leave another comment too, it doesn't matter. And it closes on the 29th of January. This is so smooth. I don't know if it's a perfect combination between the soap, blade, razor, but it feels very comfortable. And some people ask about a slant razor, and as you can see, it cuts. A normal razor would cut your hair. If this was the blade, it would cut your hair like that. But as a slant, when you drag it down, it cuts the hair at an angle, almost like a guillotine, giving you a a closer shave. Some people say it's more aggressive, but like any razor you use, if you take your time and just be careful with it, it should be fine. Okay, first pass done, lovely. I'm just gonna rinse and I will come straight back. Okay, 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 okay. Okay, back for pass number two, and still lots of nice lather in this brush. From the Stash Soapworks e-barber, and the scent on this is really nice. It's like I said with the ingredients, it's very complex, but I don't know if I'm getting some of the vanilla, I think now. It changes out the tub, obviously, once you lather it up and stuff. I'm just painting it on here. And the weather here today is very nice and very mild for this time of year for Scotch land. We had some snow over the weekend, but it's all gone. It's all melted away. Just like my savings, buying shaving gear. Okay, second pass across the grain, and yeah, we've had snow, but nothing to like what some of the snow has been in the States, especially on the East Coast. You guys get some ridiculous amounts of snow. I remember one of the times Mrs. Kevy and myself, we were in New York on holiday, and it was November, and we went on an open-top bus in November in Manhattan, and it wasn't snowing, but it was quite dull, and it was very windy, and it's the coldest I think I've ever felt in my life, you know, with the wind. And being stupid tourists, we were on the top of the bus, you know, the open top, thinking, yeah, this is great, look, there's the Empire State Building. We were so cold, we had to go back to the hotel room and sit with our hands and feet in the bath with hot water, and we had the hair dryer on our hands, everything. I was just chilled right through to the bone. It was freezing. Oh, nice. Okay, second pass done, feels good. Nice reduction again, which is what you're aiming to do with each pass. I'll just rinse off and I will come straight back. Okay, back for pass number three, and still lots of suds. I'm not shaving that here, so yeah, it's a nice scent on this soap. Very complex, but oak moss, white pepper, vanilla, black amber, cedarwood, bergamot, basil leaf, clove, nutmeg, white patchouli, musk, saffron, rose, patchouli, and vetiver. Very nice. It's Erica's take on a barbershop, but it's very different from any barbershop I've smelt, but it is a nice, nice scent, and it performs really nice. Nice glide, cushion protection, slickness is there, and it's easy to lather with the Omega S brush as well. And there's some little bits of soap that I haven't mixed in the bowl. You can see them on the bottom there. That's okay. Okay, pass number three against the grain. the Mercer 37C. And I'm just letting you guys know I have two more shaves. Well, I have this shave. I will shave again either Friday or Saturday, and hopefully I'll film it. Well, my plan is to film it, and then next Wednesday this will be coming off and the moustache, because the play starts next Wednesday evening. Actually, it might even be Tuesday. I might shave it for the dress rehearsal. But just giving you a heads up, on Friday or Saturday when I shave, I will be doing the Battle of the Adjustables. The Parker variant versus the Mercer Progress. Half my face with each one. So that'll be the shave on Friday or Saturday, because I've had a lot of questions since I've been using the Parker variant, saying, is it better than the Progress? How does it shave? Is it more aggressive? And to be honest, it's difficult to answer those questions unless you actually shave with it. So I'm going to do half my face with the Progress and half with the variant. I don't know which half. Okay, three passes done. Excellent. Okay, there's a couple little pickups. I just want to rinse this off and I will come back and do those. Okay, back for the pickups. And there is an insane amount of cream suds left in this. So I'm just going to skip. Actually, I'm just going to apply some of this to the little bits that I need to pick up. I'll just do that, have a little feel about with it. Yeah, just down here as usual. And round here. That feels good. Okay, I'll just do these little bits here. And the slickness on the soap is very good. You can probably just wet your hand, do that, and there's enough residual slickness there to shave still. It's always this bit just here. For some strange reason, I think my hair kind of grows like a star. Okay, that feels nice. Okay, as there's lots of suds left, I'm just going to scoop this out. I'm going to rub it into my face, and then I will get some good properties from the soap. I will then rinse off with hot water, cold water, come back for the post shave. I shall see you soon. Okay, we are back. Wow, that feels very good, very nice. Skin feels great. Nice close shave, excellent. Okay, no alum, no witch hazel, because I'm going to use the eBarber aftershave splash. And this has aloe vera, witch hazel, polysorbate, fragrance and essential oils, jojoba oil, chamomile oil, alum and vitamin E. So we'll just have some of that. Because there's no alcohol in this, it shouldn't sting. Just giving it a good shake to mix everything together. And we shall just have, can you see, a little splash of that. Nice. Yeah, the scent's similar to the soap. I would say there's I can smell the oak moss a little bit. It's very nice, it's quite floral again, but a nice scent, and it feels great on the skin because of the nice stuff that's in it. Very nice. Yeah, a lovely scent. E-Barber Aftershave Splash. And to complete it, Erica also sent me the Aftershave Balm. Similar sort of ingredients in this. So the last time I used the balm, I used far too much, so I'm just going to use the tiniest amounts. And I shall show you, there it is, that much. Yeah, that is enough. Even for my big Scottish face. Nice. Very nice. Feels good. Feels great. Nice scent from the balm as well. Yeah, very good. Excellent. That looks a bit tidier. Apart from this beard. It will be coming off soon, and then the moustache will just be left, and then that will be coming off. Okay, let's go over what we've used again in this magnificent shave that we had today. And I don't think I've said hello to any new subscribers, so if there is any new subscribers watching, hello, thank you for joining us. I'm sorry it's been a bit late in the shave that I've welcomed you, but it's nice to have you along here. And hello to my regular viewers. You know who you are. Okay, razor for today. Fantastic. Merkur 37C, the slant. Great razor. Two-piece. Very good. Some say it's aggressive. I love it. It was very good. Great shave. And inside that, I had a brand new Zorik blade. Very good. Very smooth. Nice and sharp. Excellent in that razor. The brush for today was the little Omega S brush, synthetic. Very good. Good backbone, splays nice, very soft, whips up the lather in no time. The soap for today, Stash Soapworks E-Barber. Excellent. And as you can see, the label, it's a... I don't think that's supposed to be Erica. It's a lady getting her leg shaved from a barber. Very good label. So that was the soap. Very nice. And there's still some left in the bowl here, look. You can, if anyone wants this, I'll put it on eBay and you can bid. I'm just kidding. We then rinsed off with hot water and cold water, very refreshing, and then we applied the E-Barber Aftershave, which was great, and finished it off again with the E-Barber Aftershave Balm. And my face feels very, very smooth, skin feels soft, very nice, a good shave. So I'll put the link to Erica's website in the description. Check it out, go and have a look, see if there's anything that takes your fancy. There is a few soaps on there, she does have some quite nice stuff. Have a look around and yeah, give her a try. Okay, that's all from me today. Thank you very, very much for watching. Please keep the comments coming. And this is the Shave-a-thon. I'm not sure what's going to happen with the closed captionings. I've had a look and I've not kind of worked out what's going on. I think YouTube have changed it, so I'll have to investigate further. So we shall see what happens. But thank you again for all the comments. Some of the links, fantastic. If you are new to this way of shaving, read the comments in the shaving videos, because some of them are very, very useful, and some products and links and stuff that people give just far superior to my knowledge. That's all I'm going to say. So yeah, check them out. Okay, until the next shave, which will be the adjustable face off. We'll see you soon, and have a nice rest of the week, and take care.